Thanks, Wilmer. Welcome and thanks to everyone for joining to this webinar on KLM Tool. I'm Vincenzo Emanuele Caridà. I'm an R&D product engineer in film business unit capacitor located in Italy, Pontecchio Chemet plant. And I am one of the main developers of KLM Tool. KLM Tool has been produced from Italy R&D Innovation Team. KLM means for Chemet Life Expectancy Model. Let's go now a little bit to the agenda for what today we will cover. I take also the laser. First of all, we perform a little introduction about KLM. What is KLM? Its characteristic, its property, why every customer, every R&D engineer in the world should use KLM tool. After we speak about the main construction in film capacitor technology, we introduce the main capacitance decreasing mechanism in film technology. We describe the KLM futures. We speak also about the logic process and the art process to get and to develop KLM tool. And then we speak also about we display to you the film series already available in KLM tool. The future series will appear in KLM tool, and finally we'll do also a live demonstration of KLM tool. Probably it will be the most funny, the most interesting part of the webinar. So guys, try to be patient to support me during the webinar, because the end will be the most interesting part that I show you. KLM, what is KLM? KLM is a powerful and nice tool to predict the life, the service life of only Chemet film metallized capacitor. It's the first in the world, in the industry world, to take in consideration voltage, temperature and relative humidity. It's really innovation tool. We implemented KLM also in software way. It's already available in our engineering center and will be available also sooner. A new Chemet design platform, KSIM 3.0, just going out next week. The main benefits of using KLM can vary depending on the situation. The main benefits is strictly correlated to the tool capability to predict the service life of metallized film capacitor. Metallized film capacitor can find wider usage in different environment conditions and in different applications like automotive, power application, like energy renewable application, like wind, solar application, power meter application, and the electronic application. The main concept is that the same application subjected to different environment condition can trigger different aging mechanism and can result in different lifetime expectancy for the same film capacitor. So thanks to KLM, the designer can improve meaningfully the project plane and can select the proper Chemet film metallized capacitor both in according with application needs, but also with the real working stress conditions. Another benefit of using KLM is linked to the unscheduled maintenance cost and events. So it has been highlighted from a photovoltaic system survey that the 54% of service costs are linked to a scheduled maintenance cost. And one of the top four failure in photovoltaic system is the capacitor fan. So thanks to Kelem, the designer, in according with the real stress working condition recorded, can reduce meaningfully the unscheduled events and the scheduled cost. So Kelem allows you to save much time, but also mainly much money. Now we introduce the main film capacitor technology. The film capacitor technology is really fascinating from one process point of view, with two metallized dielectric film. The main configuration are the parallel or one section configuration and the two series or two section configuration. Obviously, the lifetime and the performances of the film capacitor is strictly correlated to the product type technology. The main capacitance drop in film capacitor technology are the self-heating, partial discharge, electrochemical corrosion, and self-heating produced by VSC-ESC at 50-60 Hz. Now we focus step by step on each main capacitance drop mechanism. The first is the self-heating. The self-heating is the highest safety mechanism of metallized film capacitor technology. It's the ability to self-regenerate an internal drop of resistance, the ability to regenerate also a weak spot in the electric base film. And obviously the final result of self-healing process is a small dielectric metallized area clearing and a tiny loss of capacitance drop. Obviously, if the capacitor is well designed, has been built with the right material, with good material quality, with right film dielectric and the right metallization thickness and also material, the capacitance drop produced by self-healing is really negligible during application, lower than 1%. The other mechanism is the partial discharge. Just 1 second. Is the partial discharge. Partial discharge or electric corona effect indicates a localized dielectric discharge in air gaps. Yes, this the concept of this is that we have two level of voltage, the inception voltage and the extinction voltage. When the voltage across the air gaps overcome this inception voltage and a free electron is already available on air gaps, in air gaps, an electric discharge can take place. If the electric discharge, partial discharge, take place, the voltage across the air gaps drop from inception voltage to extinction voltage when the partial discharge stopped. This mechanism happens mainly at lower temperature and in high humidity content, in high humidity in harsh environment condition, because the inception voltage value is lowered at high humidity content level, but also at lower temperature. The other capacitance drop mechanism is the electrochemical corrosion. The electrochemical corrosion is due to the simultaneous presence of water and AC applied voltage. When the water is present in capacitor windings, an electrochemical cell, like you can see there, is formed. And with the voltage applied, the metallized layer could lead, could meet, could corrode a little bit in according with this relation. This reaction rate is this mechanism is proportional to temperature, is proportional to AC voltage applied level, is proportional also to the relative humidity level. So the partial discharge and the electrochemical corrosions are the main capacitance drop mechanism in field capacitor technology. Obviously, we can work to reduce this capacitance drop mechanism, reducing dead gaps, for example, in partial discharge, or also protecting better the internal element with special enclosure material like box and resin. The last capacitance drop mechanism is the self-heating. The self-heating produced by the voltage current applied at 50-60 Hz. And this can produce a little bit of self-heating and weakly impact the capacitance drop of the capacitor in the whole life, in the total lifetime expectancy. So KLM, the special factor of KLM is that it's able to include not only self-heating, not only electrochemical corrosion like other many models in the literature, but is able to include also the partial discharge. So KLM is able to include the three main capacitance drop in film capacitor technology. The only one that is the self-heating, but this is really negligible, like I said before, during application. KLM future. Like I said before, KLM is the first tool in the industry world to take in consideration the voltage, temperature, and relative humidity effect together. All the effect, all the combination of temperature, the combination of voltage together with temperature and humidity are included in KLM tool. So the main concept of KLM is an easy to design tool where the user can introduce the three main inputs, temperature, relative humidity, and AC voltage, affecting the lifetime expectancy of the capacitor, of the film capacitor. The output of the tool is the lifetime expectancy. The lifetime expectancy can be given in hours or also in years, in according with the end of life criteria selected for the product under investigation. KLM, I repeat, just to enhance the concept, has been implemented from a model developed in KEMET Film Business Unit and mainly in Italy Pontecchio plant. This model has been got by direct experimental measurement from capacitor performed in our laboratory test. So to implement KLM, it's necessary to follow this logic, this process step by step, just in order to get reliable result and to get accurate lifetime estimation for the film capacitor technology. So now we focus also a little bit about this step, just to give you the to provide you the idea of the huge work that is behind this KLM tool implementation. The first step is the boundaries condition and the electrical testing phase. It's necessary to define these four boundary conditions for KLM tool implementation. Without any definition of the above four boundary conditions, meaningfully comparison cannot be made between model result. Later, is also necessary to define a stress condition plan for many reasons to to characterize completely the product under working, under investigation in every possible working condition. Obviously, it's necessary to observe the same failure mechanism in the capacitor. If a different failure mechanism, different than standard one, happened, obviously this test should be avoided. It's necessary also to improve the model regressions in terms of performances of model, but also to represent more closely the real experimental result. And it's necessary also to perform extended test with an observation time more higher than 1 year. So this is the reason why the model, the KLM, could require so much work to implement it. So we implemented the accelerated test, real working test, real application test, with the same criteria to respect, to have the same failure mechanism in our capacitor. The second step is the post-processing of the data analysis performed for all the test. During the test, we have monitored all the main parameter for film capacitor. The main parameter are the capacitance drop, the dissipation factor increase, and also the insulation resistance drop. We monitored all parameters just to be sure that all parameters were inside the limit product, and just to be sure that any different failure mechanism happened in film capacitor. Obviously, it's necessary to take a degree of freedom to select, to make a choice to declare our life, and we've defined as end of life criteria the capacitance drop because it's the main important parameter strictly correlated to the real efficiency and to the real performance of film capacitor technology. The second step is always to, in order to use a linear regression, it's necessary to define a relative time through a ratio factor. This relative time, this ratio factor is the ratio between the lifetime expectancy in real working condition versus the lifetime expectancy in reference test condition. This ratio has been called the RO, it means observed ratio, because it has been directly observed in our laboratory, with our experimental test. With the same meaning, we have defined another ratio, another ratio factor. We have defined the Kemet ratio factor. Kemet ratio factor has a similar meaning to this. Provide you a better explanation, this ratio factor has the same meaning of acceleration factor. So higher is this ratio factor, higher is the relative lifetime expectancy in working condition respect to the lifetime reference test condition. With the same meaning, like I said before, we have defined the Kemet ratio. That is the ratio between the lifetime expectancy calculated by our model and the lifetime expectancy in the reference test condition. This function is an attainable function based on parameter, is function of temperature, is function of relative humidity, is function of voltage, and is based on our, has been built in according with Kemet experience, Kemet knowledge on film capacitor. The third step is to combine the Kemet THP model represented by the ratio RK and the experimental data result represented by RO in order to perform the linear regression. And during this stage, we combine these two ratios in order also to fine-tune the real expression, the coefficient of this expression to represent more close the reality, that is represented by vector RO. So finally, we have this linear equation, this linear regression equation with the A, that is the regression intercept, and the B, that is the regression slope. The last step of KLM tool implementation is to analyze the model performances. And we have analyzed the model performances with Minitab software, with the graph output provided by Minitab. The first graph, the most interesting graph, just to have a rapid overview of the real situation, how well our model fits the real experimental data, is the fit regression plot, where the dotted line, for example, in this case, represents our experimental result, and our model is represented by this straight line. And Minitab provides also, obviously, the expression, the equation of KLM model. Like you can see, the correlation coefficient is really high. In this case, it's 99%. And we have a lower residual standard deviation error. Another plot to see better and to evaluate after each step that we performed the test, we've analyzed the model result, is the residual plot. These plots are important for many reasons. The main is just to check rapidly, because there is another graph to perform a better checking, is to check the linear model assumption that we have performed before with our ratio factor. So it's important to see mainly, yes, the histogram residual plot, because if the histogram residual plot is showing, is displaying a normal distribution, this means we are really close to the linear model assumption. So the model performances that came at as fixed, like minimum performances, minimum target, are good fitting data. That means a coefficient of determination higher than 90%. In according with our hypothesis, we expect a linear regression, so a linear slope close to one. We expect, obviously, that our model represents very well the reality. So we expect that the residual standard deviation is lower than 4. This means that the difference between what we are in the reality and what we predict with our model is really negligible. A confidence level of 95%. And the last point that is just last in the item list, but probably is one of the most important one, is the residual normal distribution, the normally distributed. This is just to check that our model is really linear, and to verify it, this is necessary to be sure that our error are randomly distributed with normal distribution with a mean value close to zero. This one, it is not zero, but we are really close. A constant standard deviation, and in according with our confidence level, a p-value higher than 0.05. So we have checked that, after that we have checked all this topic, all this characteristic, that our model, the linear assumption model, is checked, is right, and all the model performance parameter are right, are above our minimum model performances, we can go and we can display the model, the KLM model for, in this case, a F862W054 part number. In this three-dimensional graph, you can see the lifetime expectancy per temperature and versus temperature and relative humidity at fixed voltage. In this case, the voltage is fixed to 240. To make more intuitive, I've plotted with different colors similar to thermocamera colors. You can see the blue regions. These blue regions as the meaning, as the same meaning of to define the maximum lifetime expectancy for the capacitor. So these blue regions defines the dry condition, what we can call, what we can say the dry condition regions for this capacitor in according with the this voltage. Obviously, when the product, when the model passes from these blue colors, from these blue regions to green, yellow, orange, and red regions, color regions, the product model is moving from dry condition to ash condition, and finally to test condition, mainly in the red regions, where the lifetime expectancy is lower than 10 kilowatt-hours. 10,000 hours. We can perform also a better review of this graph in a two-dimensional graph. In this case, we have plotted in the left side the same graph of the previous one at 240 WC, but only in two-dimensional way. In the right portion, we have defined the same two-dimensional graph for the same product that I mind is an F862W054 part number for 310 WC. Like you can see, also the definition of dry condition represented by blue region, ash environment condition, test condition depends from the applied voltage. You can see with lower voltage level, the blue regions is much higher respect to the 310 blue regions. The same is also for the ash regions. And like you can see there, the red regions, the ash environment, the test condition is much higher in this graph because the voltage applied is much higher. And the higher voltage in according with really ash condition, because we are speaking about higher relative humidity and higher temperature, this means higher also absolute humidity, can trigger different mechanism, can trigger ash, can stress really ash the film capacitor. And this means lower lifetime expectancy. Now we display the three film series already available in KLM tool. The first three, all the three series are SEQ200 qualified. The first series is the F862W054. It's an X2 ME suppression series. Is the new updated F862 version with higher performances. It's a great 2B series, but also with a lower cost respect to the oldest version. The other series is the F863. This is also an X2 ME suppression series. It's a miniaturized version respect to the F862B054. And also with a good THB requirement in according with 85 degree, 85 relative humidity test, 500 hours at 240 WC. The last series already available, the third series already available in KLM tool is the F41T, that is an X1 Y2 Emmy suppression series, is the last just in the mentioning, but probably is the first in robustness, is the really our proud product, is the new product that has been going out from 2-3 months. It's the first series grade 3B, and it's really withstanding also from not only from THD point of view, but also from temperature, with a temperature application up to 125 degrees. KLM, yes, we have implemented in a software way. We have implemented in a web tool application to help the all the R&D, designer, engineer, all the our customer to improve their project plan and to select the proper KEMET film metallized capacitor in according with both application needs, but also with real working condition. KLM, this is just a rapid overview of the tool that I will show, I will display later better. Is already available in our engineering center, and sooner available, practically you can say that it's already available on KEMET design platform KSIM 3.0, just going out next week. So guys, despite the, nevertheless, the big impact of this tool in the world industry, this is just the beginning. This is just the first step of a big revolution. We have showed before 3 film series already available, but we don't stop there. We proceed. We want to provide to our customer all the future KEMET film THB series in KLM web tool application. All the future KEMET THB series will be available after they officially release, after they officially launched in the market. So now is we are arrived to the most interesting part, the most funny part of the webinar, that is to show you. Just 1 second. Is to show you the KLM tool, a real application, a live demo. I perform you now a live demonstration of KLM tool, how to access it, how to proceed. Just 1 second that I'm opening. As you can see, KLM is already available in, it's just that I share. Okay.
Yes, Vincenzo, we are still just seeing the PowerPoint.
Yes. You see now? Okay.
Yes.
This, like you can see, film capacitor lifetime, KEMET, is KLM is already available in KSIM 3.0 version, and we will be to you available from next week, but like repeated before, it's already available in our, also in our engineering center. Now I explain you how to access it, how to work with KLM. It's the most for me the most emotive moments, because I've worked so much for this, so I'm really proud to show you. As you can see, there is the I've selected the time lifetime model. You can select the 3 series that are already available in KLM, F862, F863, and L41T. We select the F862 with 054 for the moment. You can select also the pitch available per the series. So in this case, we have the pitch 15, pitch 22.5, pitch 27.5, I suggest now we select just the intermediate pitch because I follow also always the law of philosopher, Aristotle philosopher, that the right is always in the middle. So just now I'm seeking I select the middle pitch. And yes, the voltage is established for the series. And now, yes, this is an SC series. When will appear also DC filtering series, do you see also the VC voltage, VDC voltage? We select also PAR number. There you can see the PAR number or rapidly also the capacitance that you need for your project. For example, I select the 560 nanofarad. From standard, KLM will provide you two mission profile. You can add other profile. You can remove the profile like you prefer. At maximum, we have fixed 10 profile because we think that 10 profile are enough to represent a real mission profile application. So for the moment, we focus, for example, only on free profile, just to make a really simple the example. In this case, okay, you can put your input voltage. In this case, 240. You can change the temperature, for example. You can put the relative humidity. Now I just perform, I put some parameter. Obviously, it just to remind you, if you introduce some parameters that are out of a reasonable range application, like for example relative humidity percentage higher than 100%, it will display a warning. Or if you put an ambient temperature higher than rated temperature series, that in this case 110 degrees, for example, if we put 111, you will display an error. The same way also if you put a voltage higher than rated voltage, in this case is 310, if you put 320, you show an out of range. So we put 240. And then there is the working time percentage, that is the percentage time that the capacitor will work on this profile. Obviously the sum of the all working time percentage should be equal to 100%. If you put a higher percentage, that is not it not represent the reality. For example, 70%, you can see that it appears a warning that the working time should be must add to 100%. So we correct this and we put 50%. And then, okay, now I put just some parameter. Like you can see, when obviously you modify a work profile, the work profile, it change the output of the model, that is the operating lifetime expectancy. In this case, in according with a capacitance drop of minus 20%, and you have the output in hours, that is 120, in this case, for this mission profile. Is 124 kilowatts, that correspond to 50 kilohertz, to 50 years. Obviously, if you put some stressful condition, for example, say 70 degrees, you can see rapidly like your lifetime expectancy decrease, also the years. And there is another output of the model, is the time per profile. The time per profile is not the lifetime expectancy for the selected profile, but is the time per profile in according with your wall mission profile selected. Obviously, if you select only one profile, for example, there now you can see I put 310, 70, and 20. There you can see a time per profile that is, for example, 17 kilowatts. But if you remove all the profile, this is much higher because this in this case, is the same of the total of time. So in this case, when you have only one profile, the time per profile is equal to your total lifetime expectancy. Obviously, if you want to change, you know, because you discover that your capacity unselected is not right for your project, or you want to be more safe, you can remove the select part number, and you can select, for example, another bigger one, for example, this, and then you can proceed with the same procedure seen before. So I've showed you also this tool that I'm really proud to share with you, with the world industry, and I'm sure that all the world industry will appreciate this tool. I'm sure that this tool will be really useful for our customer and for our R&D engineer.
Vincenzo, thank you very much for putting this together. It seems to be something that's very well received in the industry and should be a well-received tool in the industry. And thank you everybody for attending, and we'll see you on the next webinar.
Thank you to you, Wilman, to everyone that attended to the meeting as joining to see our KMET KLM tool.
Grazie, Vincenzo.
Grazie, ciao. Ciao, ragazzi. Ciao.